What's up, guys? My name is James Jenkins, and today I'm going to talk you through what I pack in my board bag for a one-month stint as a boatman on the Motu Island in Fiji. Thing on top of my board bag is my Slingshot 4.0 high roller pro and foil board. This is something that I use every day in Fiji, you know, whether it's paddling, foiling, or tow foiling behind a kite, or open water windswell foiling. This thing does the trick. This is the 4.0 version, super light. It's got a lot of volume and it paddles really well, which is why I like it. And then being only 4.0, once you're up, it really pumps really well, and there isn't any extra board kind of getting in the way of anything. So 4.0 high roller by Slingshot, absolute must have for Nemotu. In combo with that, I ride the Infinity 76 wing that Slingshot makes. This is just a great all-around wing for surf foiling. Slingshot allows you to have your wing either in position A or B on the fuselage. So depending on how much lift you want, what conditions you're surfing in, you can adjust that based on the wing and the position on the bottom of the board. So super versatile. It's a great wing to have in the Quiver, and I definitely will never go anywhere without it, but something I used every day on Nemotu in Fiji. Next thing I have in my Quiver is my 5.2 Firewire Machado Surfboards Seaside. It's a quad setup, and I'm riding the Machado Futures that he developed for this board. This is an absolute must have for the Quiver in Fiji. It goes great in small waves, and it isn't always 8 to 10 foot and pumping cloud break in Fiji. There's a lot of really fun, playful waves there. And this board was my go-to whenever it was under head high. Swimming pools, Nemotu lefts, these are, you know, weaker waves, mushier waves that you kind of want a little bit of a smaller wave board when you're surfing it, when it's small. But yeah, this thing is really fun. It's super fast. It's really loose. It packs a lot of volume for being 5.2. This board has 24 and a half liters, and I typically ride about 24 flat up to 25. So it's kind of right in the middle range of how many liters I like to ride. But yeah, this thing goes great. It's so much fun. One of the most fun boards I've ever had. It's just one of those fishy shapes that you can't really go out on and not have fun. So Seaside by Machado Surfboards and Firewire, absolute recommend, 10 out of 10. One of the most fun boards I've ever owned. And I rode this probably almost every day when I was in Fiji. Next board that I have in my Fiji Quiver is my Slater Designs FRK. This is a 5.9 by 18 and 3/8, 2 and 3/8, and 25.6 liters. So it's actually at the top of the spectrum for the amount of liters that I typically ride my boards, but it's so light, and the construction of it is so well done that having that extra bit of paddle power has actually only ever helped me get into waves faster and sooner. I actually heard, I think, an interview with Kelly talking about the development of this board with Dan Mann, and he said, put it under your arm, and if it feels like it's almost too small, it's the perfect size. I like to ride this thing basically anywhere from 2 foot to double overhead, and about as big as it gets until I need a proper step up. This was definitely my go-to short board in Fiji. Kind of when it's smaller, I like to ride it as a three fin thruster setup. When I'm just doing turns and stuff like that. And then once you start to get into more barreling conditions, I like to put four fins in there, and it just likes to go fast. Super loose, but it also holds a rail super well through turns. You know, I can push into my turns as hard as possible, and it really holds a line super well. Yeah, it's probably my favorite shortboard I've ever ridden. Would absolutely recommend to anyone who kind of wants an all-around performance shortboard and barreling conditions, rippable conditions. This thing really gets the job done. And it's super versatile in different size waves. So Slater Designs FRK, absolute necessary board for Fiji. And I don't really want to ever take a trip without one. Final board in my Fiji Quiver is my 6.10 Paizel Padillac. This was my go-to board when cloud breaks started getting washed through sets, or basically bigger than I could handle on my FRK. This board is absolutely amazing. It's a straight quad setup, which is exactly what you want out there when it gets big. This one is a 6.10 1975, 2.75 thick, and 38.3 liters. So almost 13 liters more than I typically like to ride in my shortboards. This board is freaking amazing. I love it so much. It just, with all that volume, it really paddles super, super well. And the best thing you can do at Cloud Break is get in early and have plenty of time to set yourself up. And this board does exactly that for me. I kind of like to sit on the inside section of that wave. This is a section called Shish Kebabs. It's a really fast, but also super hollow, like the in section of the wave. With this board, I'm able to sit where I want to sit, get into the wave super early, and set myself up as well as I can for the barrel. And this thing gets you in so early, it really gives you plenty of time to set up. And honestly, once you're on the wave, it's super maneuverable and feels like you're just on a shortboard on a big wave. You can maneuver it around in the barrel. It's super responsive for how big it is. And I got some of the best waves of my life on this board. And I like to combine it with this. This is my Patagonia impact vest. It just gives you that little bit of impact protection and just that perfect amount of flotation that you need to kind of boost your confidence a little bit. There's waves I went on that I probably would have pulled off on had I not had this vest on. So I'm so thankful for it. It kind of just, you know, when you're going over the falls and you know you're about to hit the reef, it gives you a little bit of a confidence boost because you know you'll probably be all right. Highly recommend an impact vest if you're ever gonna get into anything serious. My Paizel is my go-to big wave board. Gets you into a wave super early. And then, you know, the barrel at Cloud Break isn't really perfect. It'll go super hollow in some sections and then it gets really almondy. So having a board that you can kind of maneuver around inside of that wave is crucial. And this 16 Paizel paddle axe surfs just like a shortboard on a big wave. And you can paddle faster than anybody in the lineup. So, Paddleac, highly recommend to anyone who wants to get into bigger stuff. Yeah, these have been some of the most amazing boards ever. I'm super happy with my Quiver this year. And yeah, can't wait for next year.